Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. In this video, we will finish setting up our pick and scan station, and we will see how we can take full advantage of the infinite looping of a program. Let's get started. Here's our station exactly where we left it. So we had our go home, scan, get bottle in, put bottle out, pick bottle and drop bottle subprograms completed. So if we were to kind of create or run this program one by one, let's replace object, go home, double click to run the program, don't forget. Then we go get bottle in, we pick one bottle, then we double click on scan, brings the bottle in front of the scanner, then we go for put bottle out, it drops the bottle on the out conveyor, and then we could go back to the home position. Cool. Now we need to add or create a complete process out of all of this. So this will happen in the pick and scan subprogram. We need to put all of those together. We need to create an init. We need to create a main program, and we need to include the conveyor motions or conveyor subprogram calls in our program. So let's do that. With the pick and scan program, the goal is to start from scratch, go pick a bottle here, bring it in front of the scanner and put it out. As simple as that. So to do this, we will right click, add instructions, program call instructions. We will select program and run the programs one by one. So we need to first go to the home position here, click OK. Then we can press enter here, select, press enter, select program once again. The goal would be to go and get one bottle in the in conveyor, on the in conveyor first. Click OK. Then we need to go to the scan position. And then we need to go to the put bottle out here. So if we go home, get bottle in, scan, put bottle out, we should have exactly the result we are looking for. So if we first replace object and then pick and scan. Exactly like that. Perfect. So that's what we were looking for here. So now let's create our init program. So the init program will be for now as simple as calling the replace object, but I'm going to explain you why we have the init program later, in a few minutes, in fact. So add instruction, program calls, and then we'll select the replace object. So this is one step that we know we'll have to do before anything else. Another thing we'll have to do in the init for sure is to go back home, because we already want to be home before we get started with our project. So I'm going to simply control C and then control V, go here, call go home. So that's great. Then another thing that I will want to do in the init is make sure that the conveyors are at their initial position, because as I will go on and move the conveyors, at some point they will be in a given space or given position, and I will have to bring them back to their original position before getting started. So what I will do here under conveyor programs, you will see we have init conveyor position. I will simply hide the app drop here visible and then collapse that here. We have here init conveyor position. We have next part in and next part out. If you were to double click on next part in, you will see that the conveyor is moving one step forward, moving one step forward, moving one step forward. And if you select next part out, you will see that the out conveyor is moving one step forward, one step forward. And if you select init position, all the conveyors simply go back to their positions. So what I need to do is here under init, add a program call instruction, select program. And if I go down the list, I have access to the Python subprograms. So in this case, I will go init conveyor position. Click OK. If you are interested in knowing a bit more on what's inside of those programs, you can right click and edit Python script. But honestly, you should wait just a few videos. We will cover that together. So now here, I will take my init conveyor position and bring it at the first position. So right click, drag, hold, in fact, right click, hold, drag, release before here. That's always cool. So if I double click init, all the objects goes back to their original position. The conveyor are in their initial state and the robot is back to its own position. So that's honestly perfect. Now we need to trigger the next part in and next part out subprograms at the right stage in our program. So to do that, we can go here and run the pick and scan program one step at a time. So the first program is go home first. We go and get bottle in, so that's perfect. We could say that as soon as bottle in is done, we can call next part in to move the conveyor to the next position. So let's do that. So let's select call get bottle in. Just if we want to add an instruction just after an instruction, we just have to select the instruction we want to add the instruction after. Right click, add instruction. In this case, it's going to be a program call instruction. Select this one. Under select program, we will select our next part in. Click OK. Like that. Next part in. So if we do init once again and we do pick and scan, picking the bottle, moving up, conveyor moves, robot moves. In a future video in this module, so not so long, I will show you how to make sure the conveyor and the robot are moving at the same time. Now, for now, it's like a step-by-step situation. So either the conveyor or the robot are moving, not both at the same time, but I will show you how to mitigate that issue in a future video, like I said, in two or three videos. Then we have our next part here, in, next part in. Then when we put bottle out, we need to add another instruction. And this time, so again, add instruction, program call instruction. This time we need to add a next part out to move the part outward. So if we were to run it once and then select pick and scan, moving home, picking the bottle, moving the in conveyor, scanning the bottle, put it on the out conveyor, and then move the out conveyor, rinse and repeat. That's cool. Now let's create our main program. So the main program would simply be init followed by pick and scan. So we'll do that. So right click, add instruction, program call instruction. We'll select our init. Our init already has the replace object, the go home, and the init conveyor position. Then we will select our pick and scan. Click OK. Perfect. So if I run this main program now, collapse this one. I'm coming in, picking one bottle, moving to the scan, dropping the bottle, and that's it. But don't you agree that if we were just looping through that pick and scan subprogram, it would be perfect? So our init is ran once, and then we just need to run the pick and scan. So to do that, you can right click pick and scan and activate the loop option. We already saw the loop option in the first module. We just use it to create the square and repeat the same rectangle, many times over. But here in this case, we'll use it in a more useful situation where we can simply come here, run the main program, do the call init, so initialize everything, and then simply run the same subprogram many times over. So here I can increase the speed a bit to, three times. Perfect. And then it will run like that many, many times over. So if I could even like go for super fast speed, I would pick all the bottles. Here it's so fast that we don't really see the time it takes to scan it out, but it's still there. Okay, so that's pretty much everything I wanted to show you for today's video. In the next one, we will start adding animations. The first animation we will add is the open and closing of the gripper. To do that, we will use the hide and show feature. So that's the most basic way of creating small animations. There's more advanced way of doing so, like you can see with the conveyors and many other features that I will show you. But we will start from the most basic and quick one to apply to your simulation, the hide and show. Hope to see you there. Have a great day, guys.